وسلم على رسول الله. Chapter 43, Volume 1, Riyad al-Salihin, showing reverence to the family of Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah the Exalted says, of which the meaning is, Allah wishes only to remove a ridge, evil deeds and sin from you, O members of the family of the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and to purify you with a thorough purification. Surah number 33, verse number 33. Also, and whoever honors the symbols of Allah, then it is truly from the piety of the heart. Surah number 22, verse number 32. Yazid bin Hayyan reported, I went along with Hussein bin Sabra and Amr bin Muslim to Zayd bin Arqam, radiallahu anhum. And as we sat by his side, Hussein said to me, Zayd, you acquired great merit. You saw the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, listened to him talking, fought by his side in different battles, and offered salah behind him. Zayd, you have indeed earned great merit. Could you narrate to us what you heard from the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Zayd said, by Allah, I have grown old and have almost spent up my age and have forgotten some of the things which I remembered in connection with the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So accept what I narrate to you. Do not compel me to narrate what I fail to narrate. He then said, one day the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, stood up to deliver a khutbah at a watering place known as Khum, between Mecca and Medina. He praised Allah, extolled him, and exhorted us and said, Amma ba'd, O people, I am a human being. I am about to receive a messenger, the angel of death, from my Rabb, and I will respond to Allah's call. But I am leaving with you two weighty things. The first is the book of Allah, in which there is right guidance and light. So hold fast to the book of Allah and adhere to it. He exhorted us to hold fast to the book of Allah and then said, the second is the members of my household. I remind you to be kind to the members of my family. I remind you to be kind to the members of my family. Hussein said to Zayd, who are the members of his household, O Zayd? Aren't his wives the members of his family? Thereupon Zayd said, his wives are the members of his family. But here, the members of his family are those for whom zakah is forbidden. He asked, who are they? Zayd said, Ali and the offspring of Ali, Aqil and the offspring of Aqil, and the offspring of Jafar and the offspring of Abbas. May Allah be pleased with all of them. Hussein asked, for all of them, the acceptance of zakah is forbidden? Zayd radiallahu anhu said, yes, a Muslim. Another narration is the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I am leaving behind me two weighty things. One of them is the book of Allah, that is the strong rope of Allah. Whoever holds firmly to it will be guided, and whosoever leaves it goes astray. Commentary. This hadith brings out the following points. One, the members of Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was a human being. He also was subject to the inevitable law of death. Two, it stresses upon the establishment of a firm bond with the Book of Allah, namely the Quran, and lays emphasis on showing respect and honor to the members of the Prophet's, sallallahu alaihi wasallam's family. The members of the Prophet's family, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are classified into two categories. First, the wives of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the mothers of the believers. This is established from the categorical verses of the Noble Quran. Secondly, persons who have close relationship with the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they are Banu Hisham and Banu Abdul Muttalib, and include descendants of Ali, Aqil, Jafar, Abbas, and Harith. May Allah be pleased with them. sadaqah is unlawful for the latter category. Wallahu a'lam. Jazakumullah khair.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون رحمك الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين إن شاء الله for this morning that we're going to be getting one of the hadith or the 40 hadith by Imam An-Nawawi rahmatullahi alayh, with some of the explanation of Imam Ibn Rajab rahmatullahi alayh. And inshallah, this book which been explained by Ibn Rajab, I call Jami' al-Ulum wal-Hikam. Jami' al-Ulum wal-Hikam, and this book has been translated in English, although that it contains some of the weak hadith, the explanation of the 40 hadith by Ibn Rajab contains some of the weak hadith, but not all of them. And if anyone of you, inshallah, choose to buy this book in English, I'll be glad to help you to point the weak narration that is in. So why we're going to buy the book, or why we're going to obtain the book? Because the explanation of it is good. But now will be coming our party here to try to sift through this information, and we cross what is fabricated or weak and utilize what is authentic from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I had selected for this morning hadith number 13. I brought this book before here and was available, but I forgot what is the name actually in English. But Jami' is collective, okay, Al-Ulum, knowledge, and Hikam, wisdom. I forgot what is the title is in English, but inshallah I will look it up and let you know. And the book, you can get it from IIBH publication. For hadith number 13, an Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu an, عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه رواه البخاري ومسلم. Again, hadith reported by Anas, son of Malik, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحبه لنفسه رواه البخاري. None of you will be a believer unless he loves for his brother whatever he loves for himself. None of you will be a true believer unless he desire for his brother what he desire for himself. This hadith is agreed upon. The highest level of authentication. Although that the narration which came in the collection of Imam Muslim, حتى يحب لجاره أو لأخيه. The narrator had doubt the Prophet ﷺ used the term his neighbor or his brother. Nevertheless, that the hadith it shows necessity of loving to your Muslim brother, and usually even if we said your neighbor, because there is a saying in Arabic language, خذ الجار قبل الدار, search for your neighbor before you buy your house. Okay? Because like we always keep talking about environment, association, friendship, brotherhood and sisterhood, so we have to be selecting our environment. So your neighbor basically is going to have some impact directly or indirectly. Because you know, especially kids, they play with each other. They learn from each other. So you have to select the neighbor. Sometimes we go different places here and there. People selecting where is the best school, where is that, where is this. But they forget about that the worst thing that they do to their children, putting their children in the public school. Because in the public school, doesn't matter where you are, it's mostly in the places where that you understand that these people have more wealth than others. Instead of having a cable, they have a dish. And the kids are exposed to many trash in the media, all right? And you're trying to have a good child, but your child go and spend every day 5 to 8 hours with these children, and they carry these germs, these things which is corruption for their faith, and this is a serious problem. Nevertheless, the hadith, the narration of Imam Muslim, that he's saying until he loves for his neighbor. Alright, so we need to take this in consideration. And also, even if it happened your neighbor to be a non-Muslim, different of religion doesn't stop you to be good to him. Why? Because this is a means of da'wah. A means of da'wah that you show him the adab and the akhlaq and the discipline and the concern of the Muslims. In the collection of Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayh, that he narrated the hadith, لا يبلغ عبد حقيقة الإيمان حتى يحب للناس ما يحب لنفسه من الخير. None of you will reach the reality of faith until he loves for mankind whatever he desire for himself from the good. So this is a higher level now. We're not talking about your Muslim brother, but we're talking about man in general, desiring for them what you desire for yourself from the goodness. Nevertheless, that this hadith, it talks about perfection and completion of faith. It does not mean that a person, if he did not do so, he will be a kafir. Because some of us, they did not understand the language of the Quran and the Hadith, even the Arab. Okay? Not because you are American, even the Arab. The language of the Quran and the Hadith is much higher, more than what the people talk and communicate today in Arabic and in Arabia, wherever they are. And also, we did not go only by the linguistic meaning. There is a Sharia meaning understood from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and from the practice of the Sahaba. And this will take a priority over even the language. So what the Prophet meant by this does not mean the kufr. La yu'minu, none of you will be a believer, does not mean he will turn to a kafir. So if I did not desire for my Muslim brother what I desire for myself, does not mean that I became a Christian or a Jew or a polytheist or a different religion. Okay? There is something deals with the reality of Iman, okay? And something talking about the perfection and the highest quality of Iman, and something makes the Iman to be right or wrong. We are not talking about what's right and wrong, because believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in the day of judgment, believing in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, taking the shahada, this what bring you to the faith. Okay? And you are not going to be out of this faith unless you rejecting what you came with to the faith. You understand?
Yeah.
So here we're talking about things which make the Iman in a higher quality. Alright? So we're talking about Kamal. Kamal means perfection. Okay? That means a completion. Alright? Similar when we hear the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن ولا يسرق السارق حين يسرق وهو مؤمن ولا يشرب الخمر حين يشربها وهو مؤمن وقوله لا يؤمن من لا يأمن جاره بوائكه. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say fornicator doesn't fornicate while he's a believer, neither is thief when he steal he is a believer, neither a drinker of wine drinks wine while he's a believer. So if a person drinks wine, will this make him a kafir? No. You know, some of the Sahaba, they drank wine. And they've been brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they get the had, the capital punishment. And used to be a man by name Himar. And been brought to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in more than one incident. Okay? Are you there, Muhammad? Oh, you are not Muhammad. Okay, Muhammad is the other side. Are you awake? Huh? Good. How I know? Can you give me advice? Is there any way I will know that you're awake? Can you advise me how I get to know this?
You see my eyeballs.
Okay. So, and they said, so the person been brought. Finally, they beat him up again for the third time. Mm. And one of the Sahaba said, أخزاك الله. May Allah put you in shame. What the Prophet said? The Prophet defended the Sahabi who was drunk. He said, لا تكن عونا للشيطان على أخيك. Don't be a helper and supporter for the shaitan against your Muslim brother. Because he did something wrong, and we purify him from his sin by giving him the lashes. So now when you making dua against him,
Now you're assisting the shaitan. Instead, asking Allah to help him, get him out of this mess. Now you're saying, أخزاك الله. And this is not right. So that means we could not say that this Sahabi became a kafir. Alright? Even it happened that one of the rulers of the Muslims, and he led them in Salah while he was drunk. Okay? And instead of praying four, he prayed five. Okay? And after this, he turned to them and said to them, would you like me to add more rak'at? But this does not make him not to be qualified as a khalifa, or for them to make revolution against him, or not to pray behind him. It's serious, eh? But revolution, the lashes or the backlashes of it, is worse than dealing with somebody with a problem. Because when revolution take place, a lot of bloodshed happen among the Muslims. So sometimes we have to live with a problem, okay? Because we have to compare about the bad outcome of removing him, have a revolution, or keeping things running and still Islamic country, still Islamic environment, things like this. But the point that I'm trying to say here, that committing the sin does not make the person disbeliever, unless now he claim knowingly that this is okay to do it. And I don't care about what Allah is saying. This was for the old days, for the Bedouin people, for the desert. It doesn't work like this. Okay, Akhi, I feel sorry for you, but you can use my carrier if you want. The Rahim, you sure? Okay. So, also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying in the hadith, لا يؤمن من لا يأمن جاره بوائكه. He is not a believer. The term in Arabic is saying like this. But when I explain it to you, I will say is not a true believer. Okay? So he's still a believer, but he is not the believer. He is not the true believer. So the Arabic is saying, لا يؤمن, the one who his neighbor is not saved from his disturbance, he's not a believer. So now, if I have a Christian or a Jew living beside me, and I turn the TV loud, and I have party in my house, or I take the trash and put it in front of his house, I'm disturbing him. So now I became like him, I became a Jew or a Christian, none of it. I'm still a Muslim. Okay? But my behavior doesn't match with being a believer. So I'm not qualified to have A plus in Iman. And maybe have C, and maybe have a B. Okay? Mm-hmm. But I still under the umbrella of Islam and Iman. Okay? Nevertheless, we have to understand, and this is very important for our session here, what we're dealing with, okay? Nevertheless, we have to understand, among the qualities of faith, which it must be in your personality as a believer, loving the good for your brother, the same way you like it for yourself. If it's good of the dunya, or good of the deen. You understand? So you love to have a Cadillac, okay? You love to have a Mercedes-Benz. You're wishing for your brother to have what you have is something good. We are not asking you to go and buy him a Mercedes-Benz and you don't even have a bike for yourself. But there is nothing wrong. It's a wish, it's a hope in the heart. It's not going to cost you anything. But will it stem out of what? Of caring, having love, having consideration, thinking about your Muslim brother. So if this is not exist in your personality, listen carefully, because this is what we're trying to develop ourselves. All right? We try to cultivate, nourish ourselves. If this doesn't exist in your personality, so indeed, there is a deficiency in your faith and your iman. In the collection of Imam Muslim, Hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, من أحب أن يزحزح عن النار ويدخل الجنة فلتدركه منيته وهو يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر ويأتي إلى الناس الذي يحب أن يؤتى إليه. Okay? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever loves to be removed away from hellfire and to be permitted to Jannah, let death come to him while he believing in Allah and the day of judgment. And didn't stop here. It didn't stop here, okay? Look to the condition in the beginning. Whosoever loves that be removed, be a distance from hellfire, and to be entered, permitted to Jannah, let death approach him while he believing in Allah and the day of judgment, and he treats the people or gives the people or extend to the people what he want people to extend to him or deal with him in the same manner. So do not sell a false product to your Muslim brother, because you are not going to like somebody to sell you a false product. Neither you try to deceive him, because you don't want him to deceive you. So that means in a short term, treat the people in the same manner that you like to be treated. Mm-hmm. And how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam put both things, iman and treating the people. These two things, so that live with personality of caring for others. So when death come to you, you will die while you believe in Allah, the day of judgment, and that your regular behavior with the people, that you extend to them what you like them to extend you. I would like that when I need help, that my brother will give me help. So I have to be preparing myself to be also there for my brother when he asking for my help. You know, when you're moving, it's too much furniture. You get to hear that your brother is moving, relocating, whatever it is. You know how this feel, okay? You be you and your wife only, or you and the kids, or whatever. So you will be expecting somebody to come and say, brother, I got my truck, okay? The other person say, I have a hand truck. The other person say, I have my lunch hour, I'll stop by and help you. So the same things that you're expecting from the people, extend it to the people. And be your personality until death come to you. So if we are not this kind of people, we need to be these people. Because this part of our deen, this part of the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is what Islam is about. Yes, Islam is about salah. Yes, Islam about growing beard. Yes, Islam about, you understand, going to the mosque and making Jum'ah. But Islam also talk to you about your relationship with the other people. Treat them in the same manner you want to be treated by them. We see that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking to Abu Dharr, telling him, يا أبا ذر إني أراك ضعيفا وإن أحب لك ما أحب لنفسي فلا تأمرن على اثنين ولا تولين مال يتيم. سي أبو بكر. أنت أبو بكر. Where is أبو بكر؟ أبو بكر is
not here.
Okay. He say, oh Abu Dharr. The Prophet said to Abu Dharr, indeed I love you. You are a weak person, physically or your personality, okay? You are a weak. And I really love you, and I love for you what I love for myself. So as a result of this, I'm advising you, Abu Dharr, don't be Amir or in charge of even two people. Okay? And never take in charge of the property of an orphan. Okay? So now, the Prophet ﷺ setting us example, loving this Sahabi. He loves all his Sahaba. But also, the way how the Prophet presented to this person, reminding him about his love. So when he telling him about, it's not a criticism. No, I know about your personality, so I don't want you to put you in charge of security. I don't want you put you in charge or the economics or holding the book for the community. Because I know about you, but I love you. And I love for you what I love for myself. So as a result of this, I'm giving you advice. So don't take things personal when your brother talks to you or when the imam talks to you. Okay? So what was the advice? He said, do not be amir of two people. Two people and you are will be what? Three. Especially when we are traveling. Okay?
Okay.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you are three, you make one amir among you. Alright? So to be together, to be united, not to be under some confusion for us, and we have to listen to the Amir. So when there is a job and somebody in charge, he said, don't be in charge, because you are not ready for it. And what? You remember we said about what's the word in Arabic? Anybody can tell me? Each one of you is a governor. What is the Arabic word? Do not open your notebook. Excuse me? Did you say something? Yeah, this is correct, brother. This is Amir Rai in charge.
I thought it was just also the person who's watching, fending off.
No, this is Murabit. Ribat. You got it right, although you didn't attend it, but still good. Okay? Line crossed sometimes. So do not be Amir of even two people. Can you imagine if you are Amir of a Jama'ah or Imam of a mosque, or you are in charge of a city or a state or a country or the Muslim Ummah? This is a serious matter. And it's not everybody ready for it. There are some people have the personality, they can be in charge, they can be manager, they can be a boss, it can be whatever. Okay? So the Prophet said to Abu Dharr, I love for you what I love for myself. Alright? So don't do these two things. One is what? Don't be ahead of two people. And do not take in charge of the property of the orphan. Because the orphan is a little kid. Okay? And you have all this property. And who's watching there? Nobody knows how much his father left him. And the shaitan will play. Will play in your emotion and all this money and all these things. Spend, okay? Write it from the income tax or whatever. Add it, huh? Nobody watching, do it. So here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This what? So now we have to understand the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah had put him in the charge of the whole ummah because he's the messenger of Allah, and you have to give them the invitation, have to invite them, have to correct them. So the Prophet have no choice except to be in a charge, because this obligation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah had strengthened him, give him the ability to be in charge of the ummah. All right? There is hadith which reported by Nu'man ibn Bashir, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, the likeness of the believers is the way how they love one another, care for one another, assist one another, be merciful to one another, like a one single body. If one limb suffer, the whole body will suffer. So we have to understand these things. We need it to be in our life. We need it to be in our life. We a minority in the country. We are also minority even among the Muslims. We are minority in the general body of Muslims, especially when you start to talk about the Sunnah and the Quran, and you stay away from the innovation and the bid'ah, and people look at you like a stranger. You are not, you understand, you are like a lonely sheep. You don't, you understand, or the bad, they look to you in a different way. Okay? You know what I'm talking about. So now, we have to understand we need the support of one another. We need the love and the caring of one another. And part of it, caring about our children. What we mean by our children? Not the children that last name is Adley. No. Your children, that all these children are ours. We have to feel that we are uncles and fathers for them. And like I said, especially about the children, they never saw their father, or they don't know anything about the history of their father. There's some people, you understand, been migrated. Not actually migrated. They've been, came as a refugees. And some families been split. And some people then been killed. Invasion. You understand, of their countries. And after the invasion of the countries, the mother dies, the father dies, children there. And usually the churches, they go and take these children. Like what happened in Afghanistan, in Bosnia, all these places. A lot of children, thousands of children. Okay? So we have to understand what's our position. And only the love. And this love comes out of Iman. Because believing in Allah, knowing that we'll be rewarded for what we're doing. فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. As for the orphan, don't oppose, don't treat harsh. And for the beggar, don't you understand, yell at him. So we have this code of discipline in our deen. And we have to understand how to develop this love. And we care for our brothers, you understand, like we care for ourselves. And we wish for them what we wish for ourselves. Doesn't matter if this is material thing or in the deen. All right? And this what made me keep yelling at you, crying for you, begging you, coming. Because I have something and I know you don't have it. I know that I have something, I know you don't have it. And even if you don't, if you have it in words, you don't have it in meaning. And if you have it in word and meaning, you don't have it in reality and practicality. So this is the reason I keep begging for you, calm down. Let's do something. Let's unite our effort. Let's try to help each other, be sitting with each other. Let's try to get closer to each other. Okay? That's because it stems out of love, caring. But otherwise, like I told you, 100 people come or 2 people come, my name is not going to change from Imam to a Mufti or Faqih or Muhaddith. Doesn't matter you call me Sheikh or Imam or you call me Muhammad Adli. It doesn't. And I hear some brothers, although it's not part of respect for elders, okay? Some young brothers, I know them by name, say, what's happening, man? Okay. Oh, dude, All right? Muhammad Adli. You hear it Friday. You hear some brothers, they say, Muhammad Adli. Okay? I answer them, no problem. But I want them to know that it's not the proper way. Okay? I'm in the age of being a father to some of you, believe it or not. If you don't know how old are you, I can tell you. All right? Don't be deceived with the color of my beard. It's nothing except a dye. All right? And by the end of this year, I'll be 64. And by the Hijra year, I'll be 66. All right? So I'm like a father to most of you.
We are.
I know few people here, but some of you, you understand, I know that they don't have this. So, but I'm trying to tell you why I'm begging you. And like I said, it's not going to change, you understand, if 50 people come, I'm going to get a percentage more, you understand, from the masjid because more people coming now. No. All right? I can be relaxing in my house. What, do you know what time I went to sleep last night? 12:45. Keeping the struggling with one hadith to bring it to you. And come to deliver it to you. They said, Al-Qari' kal-Halib. Was-Sami' kal-Sharib. Okay? The one who's teaching or reading, preparing, like the person who milking the cow. But the one who listening is like the one who drinks the milk. So you don't have to go through the effort of milking the cow. You may even get kicked sometimes. All right? But you come and sit and relax, okay, and listen. So is the caring, the loving, okay, the realizing my duty as a Muslim, that Allah bless me with language, that Allah bless me with some knowledge, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless me with some time, and I'm making myself available for the community, but the community someplace else, with exception of few. This reality. How many Muslims they really benefit from my existence? Okay? You can count them in the right hand. This reality. People come for Jum'ah and this is it. Okay? But we see how the life was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the life of the Sahaba. Okay? Somebody like Abu Huraira, Anwar, remember when we were talking about men around the Prophet? Abu Huraira, he has no job, not because he doesn't find a job. He took upon himself that my job will be there whenever the Prophet utter a word, I'm there to record it. He divorced all jobs. Nothing. And Abu Huraira, sometimes, he did not have something to eat. And Abu Huraira, and Jibreel, you're listening? Abu Huraira, one day, he was like fainting. Okay? And the people will think that there is something like a jinn, okay, or you have a seizure, okay, or that something wrong with him, he gone crazy, and they come and keep shaking him or putting their foot, you understand, to get him up. But he say, by Allah, there is nothing wrong with me. The only thing wrong with me that I could not stand up because nothing in my stomach and I'm so hungry. I could not even erect my back. Subhanallah. But he chose this. And he made this sacrifice. To be there. Anytime the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would step out of the door, sit in the mosque, give a hadith, Abu Huraira is there to record it. You can find another level of the Sahaba. Umar radiallahu anhu, he has a partner. Okay? He has a partner in his company. They was a businessman, and they living on top of the mountain. So what he used to do, he said, he sent my partner one day to listen from the Prophet, what he teach. Because the distance and climbing the mountain and taking care of the business. And they make a shift. So the next day, Umar will come and listen from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and go teach his companion what he heard from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The sacrifice is something very important in our life. And you can get a reward if you're really serious about it, equal to what I'm doing. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that two people are equal in the reward and two people equal in the sin. A man who have a wealth, right, left, fi sabilillah, okay? Another person is poor, but he said, I wish I have like this man. And if I have it, it's not a word that he's saying. Say, if I have it, I will do the same thing like him. Open an Islamic school, build a mosque, you understand, give the orphan. The Prophet said, both of them are equal in the reward. Because this man actually did, and this man have a serious intention that if Allah give it to him, he will do the same thing. And he said, another person, he have wealth, and he's spending it in the haram, in the wrong things. The other person say what? Well, look at this man, I wish I have like him. If I get it, I'll get all this. Stretch limousine and all these women and all these drugs and have fun and go here and there. He said both of them get the same thing. Although he didn't do it, but he have a sincere intention. If he gets the same, he will do the same. Why I'm saying this? Because you can get a reward like me, or more than me. Say somebody whom Allah give him the wisdom, give him the knowledge of the deed. So he teach it to the people day and night. And somebody else doesn't have it, but they say, if Allah give me what this man have, I will preach it all over the United States. His English is broken, but I got, this is my mother tongue. I'm going to get from him. You could not sit in your house and wishing and dreaming these things, but you're going to have to get up and be there, take a note, listen to the lecture again and again, and try to practice, and you take it. Says my mother tongue, I'm going to start to do the same thing. So both of us can be in the same reward. You can do a lot, brothers. You can do a lot. Okay? But you are not getting these things with wishes and dreams. Okay? Like I said, I'm not asking anybody to stop going to work. But get some of the time. Allah give you legs that you walk in it. Give you a vehicle that you drive. Give you the ability to go to job. Be grateful to Allah. Give him one single hour. In 24 hours, it's too much for you. 1 hour for you to drive to the mosque and they pray and listen to class and talk to the imam or the members of the committee, what's going on, and go back to your job after this. Why not? Don't tell me you could not do it, because I know other people, he have time, and they play soccer ball for 3 hours. They go training for swimming and all these things for half of the day. If there is a will, there is a way. So we did not, most of us, we did not have the will. Is that right, wife? Let's be serious and let's be sincere about it. Don't tell me, but you have to convince yourself. The problem is not that we don't have a masjid. The problem is not we could not understand his broken English. The problem is you. You are not serious about it enough to do it. Otherwise, you go after it. Okay? You will go after it. You know, any of you knows a brother by name Abdullah? Used to have a small tent here in the back. Mm-hmm. You know this brother got his degree? He used to live in a tent. This man was serious. It took him 3-4 years, but he was so dedicated. He was so dedicated. Okay? He wants to get his degree. He got the degree. All right? And the brother I offer him sometimes in a rainy day. I say, brother, come and sleep inside the mosque. Yes, I know the rules. There is no sleeping in the mosque. There is this, this, that, you understand? In a rainy day, I had to beg him to get him inside. He has this dignity and he has this self-esteem. He got this thing from Walmart for about $30-$25, small tent. In the morning, he roll it. He push it against the air condition outside. I was observing, okay? Put it there, he go to work. He come back from work, he go to school. He come back from the school, he make Maghrib and Isha. And he go to sleep. 3-4 years, okay? I'd be surprised if he listening to me now, okay? You'd be surprised if he listen. But dedication, self-esteem, shooting to your goal, be serious about it. Don't tell me you could not read Arabic. Yes, you don't now, but if you want, you will. You will be able to open the Quran. Don't tell me you could not understand give da'wah. Yeah, give some time. You can do the da'wah. So we have the opportunity here again. And we have to wish for the Muslims all the good. There is nothing better than Jannah. There is nothing better than being Abdullah. There is nothing more better than learning the words of Allah. And you are not getting this by being home, being lazy, being running here and there. You need some dedication. We are not charging you money to come here. We even trying to have breakfast and coffee for you outside. What else you want, guys? What's wrong? It's time for you to wake up and think, what is wrong with me? Why I'm not doing it? This is it. We need to support each other. You know, you're getting body support or whatever, like what we're going to do after the class, inshallah. Nobody leave, I'm telling you. All right? Unless you don't have a ticket here, you can escape. I'm going to get you for some exercise, physical exercise. All right? So get a body that will become a supporter for you in the good. That he will encourage you to come to the masjid. That he will sit beside you until the class finish. That you will look in his notebook and say, I missed this hadith, what did he say? We need make support. What do you call it in this life here? I forgot what the term, and getting body support or some kind of...
Assistance?
No, not a system. Not exercise. That somebody, you understand, you be
sponsorship,
something like this. No.
Moral support.
Moral support, this is a closer word.
Motivator.
Somebody to be a motivator to you. Because, you understand, you want to play. You really want to but shoot and ball and keep going to basketball. But as soon as somebody else to show up, now you're ready to stay for an hour. But after 10, 15 minutes by yourself, you get tired, is it?
No.
But when you have somebody, what you just said?
Motivator.
A motivator, mm-hmm. Okay? That you feel there is a company there, that somebody walking with you, that somebody taking the same way and the same direction. And we need to be brothers to each other. There is nothing that we can wish for others better than Allah be pleased with the person. So we have to wish. And this wish is not only a wishing, sitting, dreaming, daydreaming, but it takes action. The mosque is open for you. I'm here for you. And we need to organize ourselves. We need to be like one body, like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us. We'll stop here, inshallah. Jazakum Allah khairan for attendance this morning. We have in our program, okay, after we take the attendance, we're going to have the exercise, physical exercise, for 10 minutes only, because I don't want to scare you from the first meeting. And also, after this, we're going to have the verse, Jazakallah khairan. We're going to have the verse from Surah Al-Kahf. And after this, we're going to have a small snack. And by this time will be the time to make, inshallah, the Ishraq prayer. And you can leave if you want, or you can stay. Any comments, any concern, any correction? Any of the young boys planning to come again, inshallah? Did we agree, everybody, that we're going to make Saturday of every month social gathering and will be The camping night also, is this is acceptable? How many people support this idea? And how many people will be sneaking at night and leaving and going back home? I know some people, it's the first time, this is okay. But next time we're going to make sure who left after 12 o'clock and all these things.
He even had his hand raised.
You were speaking on the Hadith. Isn't that part of the sweetness of faith, Aki? And isn't the scholars also say that go for the sisters as well?
Not from a brother to sister, from sister to sister.
That's exactly what I was saying.
Sister, yes, sir. Jazakallah khair. Anything in Islam, you have to know the ruling. Anything in Islam applies to men and women, unless there is other injunction comes in Islam to say, this only for the brothers, or this only for the sisters, okay?
No.
So when none of you will be a true believer until he love for his brother what he love for himself, okay? That mean I love for Mustafa what I love for myself. I love for Yahya what I love for myself, okay? And also sister, so and so will love for sister, so what he love for herself is the same thing. Same thing, you understand? I wish I have a believer woman, a good wife. Also the sister will wish for her sister to get a good husband, a believing brother, to take care of her, maintain her. You understand? A sister come and learn some verses from the Quran. So also wish the other sisters, they attend the class. These things, okay? Zakumullah khair. Any comments, any correction?
I have a question in regards to the hadith that Habib read. That the offspring of Ali, Jafar, Abbas, and Akil are ineligible for the zakat. I know who Abbas, Jafar, and...
All of this is the uncles.
Akil, I never heard of him. Is his uncle as well?
Yes.
Okay, alhamdulillah.
Right. Yes, Mustafa?
Yes.
I'm sorry, was somebody here?
I'll wait.
Thank you.
Two questions, I'll make them brief. Just on a note that he mentioned, you know, when the person says that, to read the hadith, the one who, your child, if they memorize Surah Baqarah and Surah Imran, that on the day of judgment they'll be shaded, the parents will receive two cloaks and nothing can touch them. And the Quran will call the child, you know, to recite and they'll descend. But by memorizing those two hadiths, it says a boy, but does that apply to a girl, or is even that hadith authentic? Where if they memorize Surah Baqarah and Imran, that the parents will receive these two cloaks from Allah that will be like nothing can harm them, inshallah. That's the first question.
Okay, again, anything in Islam, same apply to men and women, apply to boy or a girl, okay?
Yeah.
Unless the Prophet will make exception. This number one. As for the hadith, I don't record the hadith to be exactly with this wording, but if there is a hadith and if this is authentic, it will be applied also for the girls. Okay?
Yes. The next question was, we know about the believers, like if they commit a sin that doesn't make them kafir. Now what about someone who prays every once in a while, a Muslim, they pray, they don't pray a lot, they don't pray often, they don't come to Juma, but once in a blue moon, or, you know, they make salat once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
What is that characteristic of that person?
What do you think?
I'm asking you, I don't know. Because I don't want to imagine. I hear different things, but I'm asking you. Sure.
Like I said, the kufr are degrees, and the faith are degrees, and the nifaq is degrees, okay? So, does not mean if somebody act in a formality of kufr will make him a kafir. This is the ruling. Listen carefully. It's not because somebody acting in a formality of kufr will make him a disbeliever. That means he is not a Muslim anymore. Unless he will say, there is nothing called salah, I don't care, you understand? This is an old fashioned, okay? So now rejecting Quran or something from the Quran, this what will make him a kafir. Not committing the sin itself. The committing the sin is ma'asiyah, disobedience to Allah. But rejecting the order, okay, and denying its existence knowingly, this is what will make him a kafir. So those people who come sometimes to the salah, they still know that salah is a must, okay? And even when you discuss with them, say, "Akhi, I know I'm not doing good, but inshallah, akhi, may Allah forgive us." So he still believe in Allah, and that he begging Allah to forgive him. And sometimes and when Ramadan come, you find him the whole month, you understand, but he's still a Muslim.
The hadith is what separates us and the kufar is the salah also, right?
Yes, sir. Right, sure. But so does not make him a kafir out of Islam. The kufr is degrees, okay? And there is an act of kufr does not make a person being a kafir, all right? We have to be very careful of this issue. Mustafa.
Allah speaks about when you were saying about us being a community, Allah speaks about the will, having the willpower to want to do the right thing. And he spoke about it'll be difficult to do the good, to do the right. It'll be difficult to do good deeds unless you have the right spirit, Allah says. You know, like when he said on Juma, yeah, you had a dinar aminu, come to Juma, the believers, right? And if a believer, if a person doesn't come to Juma without a valid reason, okay, they could still be a Muslim but not a believer. He didn't call the Muslim to come to Juma, he called the believer to come to Juma. So what if a person didn't come to Juma knowingly?
He will be a sinner, he will be a Muslim, Asi, a sinner. If a person still believe in Allah, believing that Juma is obligatory and he did not make the Juma, is not going to turn him to a kafir.
Okay.
That means a Yahudi, a Christian, a Jew, going to hellfire forever. He will be punished, you understand, for his mistakes. Mm-hmm. But in the final, he's going to paradise.
Yeah.
He still testified to La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. This never changed. He believed in the angel, believed in the day of judgment, okay?
Okay.
But we are not encouraging the people. We don't wait until you understand you go to this level of Iman. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Iman bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah. 70 some branches. So some people they have 10 degree in man, some people they understand. But the seed of Iman is there.
Yeah. Mm.
Never been taken out. Mm. And there is a possibility with some rain, this seed will come back again, to give you a flower, give you a tree. Okay? Mm-hmm. But the seed, there is difference between getting a shovel and take the seed out of the dirt now. Now when he smells, he understands the kufr, and say there is nothing called God, there is no prayer, there is no Quran, I don't care. This is a different story.
Mm-hmm.
But it's still the person, you understand, believing and know. And when even you talk to him, you say, brother, I know. You don't even have to tell me. But make dua for me, akhi. This is the way how they say it, you understand? Because it's still there in their heart.
Yeah. One more question, Sheikh. They asked Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about, like you said, about the drinking. He said that you're not a believer while you're drinking, or while you're stealing, fornicating. But they asked him, could you be a believer and be a liar? And he said, no. That you could not be a mukmin and be a liar at the same time. Could you explain that?
I'm not going to be a perfect mukmin and being a liar at the same time.
Okay.
That means, guys, that I'm saying, somebody in email like this, somebody like this, somebody like this, somebody like this, okay? Mm-hmm. We have 500 people in aeroplane. Some people, they are business class. Some people, first class. Some people in the back. They get in a special service and special treatment. But all of them go to the same destination.
Yeah.
But are you comfortable like the person who's sitting in first class? You're not. We have, you understand, some seats, maybe some of you never saw it. Almost like a total recliner, that what you call it, this one that you, what do you call, lazy boy chair or something like this? Exactly, the aeroplane like this. Is that the wide, is that wide, okay? And you pull the finger and still like this, and now you stretch totally, you be like sleeping. It's not like a person who is sitting in a chair, okay, in economic class, that barely can even move like this. So we could not get people out of the fold of Iman because a mistake or a sin that they do it sometimes or they do it every day. This is the mercy of Allah. Why we're going to make it tight if Allah make it like this? But don't leave yourself until you be falling down, down, and after this, Allah knows best what's going to happen to you before you die. So we have to be careful, alright? Jazakumullah khair. Alright, we're going to close for this session. Subhanak Allah wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Alright guys, now find a partner. I'm not going to let you go. Alright? Everybody, two people, get a partner. Yeah, we're going to...
I'll make you sweat.
Yeah, we're going to make you sweat for 5 minutes. I know, it's still awake.